Now let's start with general features of lung. In this one is right lung in my hand. We will see border, surfaces and relations of lung with its all relations. Now this one is right lung. Both borders and surfaces are same in right and left lung. This one is apex, this is base. Now here you can see there are two fissures. This one is oblique fissure and this is horizontal fissure. Now because of these two fissures, there is presence of upper lobe, middle lobe and lower lobe in right lung. But in left lung, there is presence of only one fissure and this one is oblique fissure. Therefore, in left lung, there is presence of upper lobe and lower lobe. Now, which borders, which parts present in this? Now, you know, there are two lobes in left lung, three lobes in right lung, two fissures in right lung, but one fissure in left lung. Now, which borders and which surfaces are present? This is right lung. Now, this one is anterior border. Now, this border is sharp and it is sandwiched in between this posterior surface of sternum and pericardium. Next is posterior border. Now, this border is rounded and this one is lower border. Now, this lower border, it is again sharp. Now, this lower border separate surfaces. Now, which part? This is costal surface. This is medial surface of lung. Now, this is medial surface. This one is costal surface. And this is base. Lower is base of lung. And upper part is apex. Now, this is normal anatomical position of right lung. Therefore, we will revise base, apex, anterior border, posterior border, inferior border. Now, its surfaces, medial surface, costal surface, then fissures, horizontal fissure, oblique fissure, lobes, upper, middle and lower lobes. This is about right lung. Now, which structure comes in relation with this? Now, this is medial surface. In relation with this medial surface, there is presence of this medial surface is divided into two parts. Which two parts? Posterior part and anterior part. Posterior part is vertebral part, anterior part is mediastinal part. Now, this posterior part comes in relation with upper 10 thoracic vertebra, body of upper 10 thoracic vertebra. Now, this remaining part, anterior part, this is hilum of right lung. In hilum of right lung, structure which are present from above downward. Which structure is present from above downward? Bronchus, artery, bronchus, vein. These bronchus, artery. Which artery? Pulmonary artery. For it, then again bronchus, then pulmonary vein. Therefore, bronchus, artery, bronchus, vein. Vein is pulmonary vein, artery is pulmonary artery. These are structure present in hilum from above downward in right lung. Now, remaining relations. Now, this is notch, cardiac notch. In relation with this cardiac notch, or you can say cardiac surface, there is presence, or this surface comes in relation with right ventricle, part of right auricle, right atrium. Now, here there is a part which comes in relation with superior vena cava. This comes in relation with inferior vena cava. There is a depressed line here, and this is, it comes in relation with arch of azygous vein. Now, remaining other small structure here comes in relation with this trachea, then esophagus comes in relation with this. Now, this is mediastinal surface. Next, this is costal surface. Now, in relation with costal surface, there is presence of depressed and elevated part. Now, depressed and elevated part. Now, this depressed part is formed by ribs and this elevated part is formed by intercostal spaces. This is about its costal surface. This is about right lung. Now, left lung. In relation with left lung, this is now left lung. This is normal anatomical position of left lung. Anterior border, apex, base, posterior border, inferior border. This is costal surface. This one is its medial surface. This is posterior part, vertebral part. This is anterior part or mediastinal part. Now this is hilum of left lung. In this hilum of left lung, structure from above downward, artery, bronchus in relation with this, and then lowermost structure here is vein, artery, bronchus and vein. This in relation with hilum of left lung. Remaining part, this is large depression, this is cardiac impression. In relation with this cardiac impression, there is presence of left ventricle, part of right ventricle, then part of this left auricle. Remaining structures in relation with this. Now this is depressed part in relation with posterior aspect of this hilum, and this is for arch of aorta, and this is for descending thoracic aorta. This it comes in relation with this. Now here and here, part of esophagus comes in relation with this medial surface. Now these are relations of this medial surface of left lung. And in left lung, you know now there is presence of single oblique fissure and two lobes, upper and lower. Now you can see here this lungs, these are elastic and friable in nature, and you can press it easily, and texture is just like a sponge. And you can see in adult lung, it just like there is blackish shadow, and this is because of there is deposition of carbon material inside this lung. Therefore in adult, color of lung is slightly black. And this is all about general features of lung.